Welcome to the show. This is Category 5 Technology TV, episode number 480 for Wednesday, the 30th of November, 2016. Nice to see you. Tonight, we are going to be kicking off our Action Cam Showdown. In the first of the two-part series, we're going to be looking at the DJI Osmo. It's a 4K action cam with a built-in 3-axis gimbal. So you want to stick around? We're going to be checking that out. Over in the newsroom, Sasha Dermatis, how are you?
I am great. Hi, everybody. Here's what's coming up in the Category5.tv newsroom. Hackers can hear you even if you don't have a microphone. San Francisco's public transit system has been exploited by automated ransomware. More than 130,000 records of U.S. Navy employees have been leaked. SD cards aren't just for cameras anymore, so it's time for a new standard. And Google's artificial intelligence gives robots the ability to dream. Stick around, the full details are coming up later in the show.
This is Category 5 Technology TV.
Welcome to the show. It's so nice to have you here. And tonight we've got an exciting show for you. First of all, you remember Chipolo Plus? Chipolo Plus is a coin-sized device hidden within this box. And should I actually open it up? Do we want to do it?
Yeah.
We're giving some of these away, folks. Head on over to cat5.tv/Chipolo. And you'll see a link there. And we're giving them away. Not only are we giving one away, but we're giving one away for you and one of your friends or loved ones or something like that. So here we go. There it is. There's Chipolo. And what Chipolo does, it's a tracker device. Hmm. So it has an app that you can actually find things that you've lost. There you go. You can find it on a map. You can make it beep.
Oh.
All kinds of stuff with Chipolo. And we're giving those away. So head on over to cat5.tv/Chipolo. And I've got a couple here to give away as well.
And so for your friends.
For you and your friends. We're gonna check this one out on the show at a later date. But in the meantime, just in time for Christmas, great little stocking stuffer. cat5.tv/Chipolo. And of course, we sell them there as well. All right. Lots of great stuff on the show tonight. Yes. First of all, nice to see you.
It's been
this is a surprise, actually.
It was a surprise.
This is the biggest surprise of all.
The biggest surprise is that Sasha's co-host tonight. Oh, wait. No, Erica's here.
I just walk in. Hey.
Yeah, hey, everybody. So we scrambled just before the show to set up another camera, get microphones set up. Speaking of microphones, Sasha, say
can
hello.
Can you hear me? That's right. We got new microphones.
Can you hear her
yes.
now, folks? Okay,
you
first of all, thank you so much to everyone who supported us to grab some microphones. So we actually picked up two, and these are going to help us in the newsroom. And we got a great deal on those, too. But some of the cast of the show pitched in to get those, and we've had some contributions come in to help out with that as well. And we just had, like, there's all kinds of things that we need to do here at Category 5, and your contributions really, really help us to do it. So we've got a microphone on Sasha's head after 2 weeks of struggling with that. That's fantastic. I had to put a new hard drive in our server this week, which incidentally was more expensive than I expected because we got a 3 terabyte hard drive to put in there and found out that the interface for the SATA controller didn't support over 2 terabyte drives.
It was a really good that
it was a great deal.
Came in
yes.
as they did, and absolutely they're being put to good use, so keep it coming.
Yeah, and just so you know what, and we're volunteers here, but just so you know right off the bat, just as we're kicking off the show tonight, our server houses all the back episodes of Category 5 TV. Mm-hmm. It's also used when we produce the episodes. So tonight, for example, when the show is done, we're going to put the files on the server. That's about 40 gigs per episode. Then we produce it down and create the files that are available for you. Our server was completely full, so every week for the past month or so, I've had to delete things in order to make room for each week's episodes. And so that's been really, really tough, and it was getting to the point this week where I didn't have anything left that I could possibly delete without losing something. So got a new hard drive, but needless to say, I also had to buy a new controller as well. So I got a 4-port SATA controller that's PCI Express. So thank you to those of you who have contributed, and those who are shopping with our Amazon links, our partner links,
and
everything.
Christmas is coming, and it's so super easy. This past weekend, I did all of my Christmas shopping already, and all I did was use the affiliate links, and a little piece, I don't pay more, a little piece of that goes back to... Well, us here. And it's really like it's pain-free, easy, feels good.
It doesn't go into our pockets, just to be clear, too. It pays for the lights to be on, it pays for our streaming bandwidth, and it pays for the expenses that we have here at the show. Mm-hmm. So we appreciate that very, very much. And Sasha and I were looking at the report just before the show because she wanted to see the things that she had ordered, and it gives us about 6.5% shopping through Amazon. So it makes a big difference, and it doesn't cost you any more. All you have to do is just shop through our partner links, which you'll find at category5.tv on our website. So thank you.
You're welcome.
Thanks, Sasha. All right. Are we set?
We are set.
Here at Category 5 TV, I love cameras, obviously.
I think so.
Cameras are a great tool. And these days, cameras have evolved astronomically. Whoa. I mean, we went from little action cams that shot very poor video, people using cell phones to shoot video, to now the DJI Osmo 4K action cam.
Oh, boy.
We've stepped outside of the paradigm of a video camera now. And you may have seen the DJI Osmo where you can put your phone on a three-axis gimbal. And that's cool, but I'm going to tell you, if I wanted to shoot video with my phone... Then maybe that's the answer.
It's like this, you know, you got a finger in the way.
It just looks miserable. Plain and simple. You've got a lens that's this big.
And then you
got
to go into your iCloud. I was going to say, when you're deleting stuff off your hard drive, that reminds me of my iCloud every day.
Oh, yeah? Similar kind of scenario?
Yeah. Should I delete this fond memory to get this fond memory?
Yeah. Well, I'm not one to like... video that's shot with a cell phone, or pictures that are taken on a cell phone.
No.
So this is the next evolution in the DJI Osmo series, and it includes DJI's 4K action camera. And this is, you know, similar camera to what you would see on their drones, and similar kind of gimbal system. Should we fire it up and actually take a look?
Yeah.
First of all, okay, switch. Ooh.
What?
More switch. Now it's kind of flimsy and feels kind of... Like a disco ball.
Like,
yeah, it just spins and spins, right?
Wow.
Let's fire it up and see what happens.
I want to take the skiing. Oh. We need, like, the music in the background.
I'm going to hit record here, and let's see what... look at this.
Wow.
So it's the same DJI Osmo system as far as the gimbal, how it functions and everything like that. So I have, now if I turn it around here, you can see I have a control pad here. This is like a thumb pad that I can control the actual camera, move it around.
Oh.
I've got a couple of different controls. I've got a trigger right here. So if I want to quickly shoot at you, I can do that. If I click on it three times, it's gone into selfie mode. So now I'm actually looking, it really, really quickly spins around, nice and smooth video.
That pan is so nice.
Hey, Sasha.
I love it.
So you see what the gimbal system does.
Wow.
Is it makes it so that even though this is a handheld camera, even though I'm moving it like this, it's nice and stationary and nice and smooth, right? So it kind of has an intelligence to it and moves in a nice, smooth, fluid motion.
It also looks amazing.
It feels like it's like a futuristic robot. And it's like making the video camera seem so obsolete now.
Totally different paradigm, eh?
It's different.
I'm recording here to a micro SD card from Kingston, and it just records directly, and there you have it.
Wow.
A couple of specifications. Let's talk about the camera itself, shall we?
Yes.
Okay, so the camera, as I said, it's a 4K action cam. The camera itself shoots at either 24 or 25p, so it's cinematic mode, looks absolutely incredible, and you get some really nice smooth video there. Look at that. Like, you can see how much I'm moving it around here.
And doesn't it also have Wi-Fi for modern?
It does have Wi-Fi, so you can actually fire up your app on your phone. So DJI Go has this app. Let me pull it up for you so that you can actually see this. And you know, the apps are never something that I like to necessarily focus on with a review. But in DJI's case, it is kind of cool that you can set this up as something that is going to allow you to control and view what's on the camera screen. So this becomes a bit of a monitor for the camera. So all I have to do, I need to connect to this as basically a Wi-Fi network. So the camera has a built-in Wi-Fi transmitter. So on my phone, I just have to bring up my Wi-Fi settings. It says I'm connected to Osmo. And now I can bring up the DJI Go app. And almost immediately, I've got video coming off of the camera. There we are. Okay, so with that video, now I'm hitting record. There you go. Look at how smooth this is. As I move the camera around, right? Now, I just lost connection. No, I didn't. It just brought up my Wi-Fi settings for some reason. Let's try again. All right, here we go. It kind of felt like I lost connection there. But it was actually just my phone. There you go. Okay. So it's a little bit choppy. You can see that, but it is just a monitor. The video itself, here you are. It's not choppy. It looks good. There you go. And I'm moving the camera around all over the place. What I like is that you can get these nice, smooth videos, even though, you know, my hand is shaky, right? I've been drinking a lot of coffee today.
And I don't have any milk in my coffee, so it's just sugar.
So there you have it. Specifications-wise, it shoots up to 120 frames a second at 1080p mode. Wow. So you've got a really nice slow motion. But you can also shoot the 4K, as I mentioned, at up to 25 frames a second. So it's not slow motion at 4K, but it's nice crystal clear video. And that gimbal system really gives you a nice smooth video. And I'm still connected here. You can go, apparently, you can take this up to about 85 feet from the transmitter.
And that's crazy.
Well, you figure, like, say you were in the field with me.
Yeah.
You could hold this.
Yeah.
I could be walking around with the camera doing run and gun.
Yeah.
And you can see what's going on and control the shots from here. Huh. So I can actually do some controls with my finger here on the screen. And I'm not overly familiar with the entire controls, but there are controls here that I can work with the screen itself. And that's the DJI Go app. But from here, I've got full control over the camera entirely. The gimbal, of course, is built in. Everything is built in. It supports time-lapse video and does some super smooth panoramas. I don't know if you've ever seen anything that can quite do this, but let's just say, you know, I'm going to put the camera
a 360,
here.
360,
yeah. Yeah, okay.
That's
so
cool.
Then,
so if I go off a ski jump and I do a 360, the camera will follow me? Huh?
Don't know how you figure.
Maybe?
This is a run-and-gun camera, so you've got to have somebody operating this. This isn't one that you're going to put on your helmet or anything like that, right?
I'll get Sasha to go beside me.
You guys seeing this? Huh? It's just going and going. Now, there is a stop. If I speed it up here, you'll see it only goes to there. So that was, what, about three rotations?
Yeah.
I'd say, somewhere around there. The smartphone holder, there is a smartphone holder that will place your phone right here, which is pretty cool.
Yeah. The photo burst, you can do 7 shots per photo burst.
You know what, that's pretty cool because you can take pictures like that.
That's
so if you're doing some action cam shots.
That's the only way I ever get a good shot is if it's
the photo burst.
I do the burst and then I'm just like, okay, that one. Not those ones. Delete.
So that's the DJI Osmo, and that's the 4K camera built into the gimbal. What do you guys think of that? You can pick one up at cat5.tv/Osmo, and that's spelled O-S-M-O. There you go.
Wow, it's probably the coolest camera I've ever seen.
Any questions about that one? I do like
anything in the news?
It's a different feel to it than using any kind of other action camera that I've ever used. It's different.
And
you can't mount it to anything.
And the fact that it's just one hand use, it keeps a whole other hand free. When I used to hold the camera, I'd have my hand here and,
Well, and with the gimbal system, you don't have to worry about holding it perfectly smooth either.
No.
It does have a tripod mount on the side here, but it's a little bit strange because it's on the side.
90 degrees.
Yeah, so if you put it on a tripod, the camera's going to be looking the wrong way. So I'm not too sure on that one, but that's
a little
bit...
Not the whole 360, yeah.
Yeah, but that does allow us to have some expandability as long as your tripod has a vertical mode. All right, well, check it out. It's cat5.tv/Osmo, and you'll be able to check out that camera and find out more about it. Now, this is the first of a two-part series on action cams, and we're going to be comparing all of our action cams together. Tonight was the first one, and we've got a showdown coming next week on episode 481. And on that episode, we're going to be comparing the quality of several 4K action cams, so you don't want to miss out on that, especially if it's on your Christmas list or you're planning on picking one up for somebody. You want to make sure you check that out and find out what one's going to be the best for your use case.
You know, the problem I have with these amazing shows is that I didn't know I wanted that camera.
Now you do.
And I feel like next week I'm going to want like five more. It's going to be horrible.
It's going to be terrible. You're going to have to choose. But we're going to compare them in such a way that you're going to be able to find out, okay, well, mm-hmm. which one is my favorite? Right. Because we can look at this and say, I love that for run and gun. I love it that I can take this out and shoot some really good smooth video. But if you're skiing, you're not going to be holding this.
No.
Right? So something else that we may be presenting next week may be more appropriate in that use case. Right. But this is pretty sweet for your dad standing on the sidelines shooting video of you as you go down the hill. So could do some really neat stuff.
Oh, yeah.
But the video quality is so good that I think it's kind of exciting because we're seeing a transition in not so expensive. Like, we're not talking $30,000 for a camera.
No.
And we're getting nice, smooth 4K video. Cool stuff. All right, we've got to take a really quick commercial break, and we'll be right back, so don't go anywhere.
Now here's another great way you can support the shows you love from the Category5.tv network by shopping at GearBest.
That's right, Jeff. Cat5.tv/GearBest. It's an online store for the geek streak in you.
Or the loved ones.
Well, of course. I mean, especially your loved ones, right? Because Cat5.tv/GearBest, quite frankly, has all of the greatest tech gifts that you could ever hope for at rock-bottom prices.
Do they have cell phones?
You betcha. Cat5.tv/GearBest has a wide assortment of unlocked Android cell phones and tablets.
What about consumer electronics? Those make a great gift.
Absolutely. From high-tech watches to action cameras, headphones, even virtual reality headsets. Cat5.tv/GearBest has you covered. They literally have it all, Jeff. Literally.
Really?
It's like a superstore right from the comfort of your own chair, at your computer, through the interweb.
Yeah. There's no way they have it all.
It's true.
It's just a bunch of random electronics.
Test me.
What about clothes?
Yep. Both men and women, fashionable apparel at rock bottom, super duper prices.
Kind of like this?
Well, look at this coat. What do you think? It's a slimming mock leather jacket.
I love it.
It's available for less than $30 plus free shipping at cat5.tv/gearbest.
All right. You kind of got me there.
Wow. Any other questions for me, Jeff?
Now that the winter has passed, flying season, do they have any good deals on, say, drone copters?
Oh, my goodness. Well, check this out. Dude, they have everything. Check out over 500 various drones. And not only that, they're available marked down by about 30 to up to 63% off the regular price.
Love it. What's the website again?
Well, you're going to find GearBest on our partners' pages for any of your favorite Category 5 TV shows like New Every Day, Category 5 Technology TV, The Pixel Shadow. But of course, if you want to shop absolutely right now and you want to go straight to the site, all you have to do is visit cat5.tv/GearBest.
See, that's easy. cat5.tv/GearBest.
That's right. Happy shopping.
Now you
we're
can
watching
see,
it on 55-inch TVs.
Now you can see the pores on their face.
Yes.
Exactly. That's what I hate when I go to my dad's. Like, I'm still using the HD TV. I go in his Ultra HD.
Mm. And you hate that?
Yeah.
Or it just makes you jealous?
A little bit of both. When it pans and zooms and you're just like,
the clarity can be distracting.
Yeah,
I have a 4K TV.
Because like, I don't even pay attention to the storyline. I'm paying attention to their faces. or what they're wearing or how illuminated
just
it
like,
looks.
Ooh, I can see their pores.
Yeah.
A lot of times I will think to myself when I'm seeing something in like ultra, like HD 4K, yeah. I think to myself, do I look like that on camera?
Yeah. Then, it just, and then I'm like,
we're upgrading to 4K, folks. There you go.
It's going to be great.
No.
All right. We ready to get back into it?
Yep. Yep.
All right, welcome back. This is Category 5 Technology TV, and this is episode number 480 for Wednesday, the 30th of November. Now, our recordings here at Category 5 TV are trusted only to solid-state drives from Kingston Technology. Revive your computer and improve performance and reliability over traditional hard drives with Kingston SSDs. I'm Robbie Ferguson. Please help me welcome tonight Erika Lalonde and Sasha Dermatis. Hey, you two.
Hello.
And make sure you get into the chat room. Erica's watching. I think you're in the chat room
I'm in the chat room.
Yeah.
I love the chat room. Can I just like a small chat room funny story of the week?
Absolutely.
Okay, I wasn't actually in the chat room when this happened, but we were decorating for Christmas at the clinic, and my boss's wife, who is the master decorator really of the clinic, runs in and she's super excited because she's bought like all these new Christmas decorations and she wants to show them to me. And I'm like, well, what'd you get? It's in this big bag, right? She's like, what'd you get? And she was like, a whole bunch of sparkly balls. And I laughed.
What are the chances?
And she had no clue why. And then I was trying to explain it, and I realized how ridiculous I sounded explaining it. I have a friend named Sparkly Balls.
He's in the chat room. He's right now. He's watching.
He's my friend, but I don't know his real name. His name is Sparkly Balls.
Sparkly Balls isn't his real name?
That's what I thought.
I learn something new every week.
From birth, that changes everything.
I thought his parents were really goofy.
All right. Name him.
I can't think of a name. We've got to think of a name right now. Well, he's Sparkly Balls. Oh, dear. Okay. We're going to move on. Tonight, we're streaming with the Nimble Broadcaster. We're on Roku. We are available through our website, Kodi. HLS feeds are up and running. Make sure you give it a test. Let us know what you think. Let us know how it's running for you. And this week, people are buying the Raspberry Pi kit on our website, cat5.tv/pi. Make sure you check that out. And that is a great way to support the show is to shop through our online store. Mm-hmm. All right, Sasha, I'm gonna throw over to the newsroom. We've got a fair bit of viewer questions, viewer comments tonight, and I think we're gonna get right into the news, and then we're gonna come back to it. So if you've sent in a question or comment, we want to cover it tonight. I want to give us some extra time after the news, so stick around. We're gonna address those in just a couple minutes time. Okay. So over to you, Sasha Dermatis.
All right. Here are the stories we're covering this week in the Category 5.tv newsroom. Hackers can hear you even if you don't have a microphone. San Francisco's public transit system has been exploited by an automated ransomware. More than 130,000 records of U.S. Navy employees have been leaked. SD cards aren't just for cameras anymore, so it's time for a new standard. And Google's artificial intelligence gives robots the ability to dream. These stories are coming right up. Don't go anywhere.
Jeff Weston.
Yaman.
You're building a brand new, beautiful website.
What?
Aren't you?
No. Am I?
Oh, you're a terrible actor.
What?
This is where acting comes into play.
Oh, I didn't know we were acting.
You're supposed to act.
Okay, fair enough. All right.
Yeah, I'm building a really cool website. Are you building a really cool website? You need hosting. One of the things about a hosting account is you don't want to have limitations put on your website.
It's true.
How much hard drive space do you have? How many email accounts? How many domains can point to it? Well, we've got an amazing deal for you. For a very limited time, cat5.tv/dreamhost. For just $5 and a bit of change per month, you are going to get unlimited website hosting, unlimited email accounts on that hosting service. You are also going to receive a free domain name.
Ooh.
So your own .com.
Nice.
To put that amazing website that you've been working on
there.
If you want to build a WordPress site, fine. Sign up. cat5.tv/dreamhost.
Just don't put Panama Papers on it.
Just don't do it. But hey, it's a great deal, folks. Best deal you're going to find. $5 and change per month. Go to cat5.tv/dreamhost.
I drink my coffee backwards.
You drink your coffee backwards? This is the randomness.
Randomness
we deal with, folks.
I thought it was look.
and there's our commercial for the Category 5 mugs.
Look, it's on both sides. You can pick them up at shop.category5.tv.
Look at this
marketing. Righto.
Righto, mate.
I'm Sasha Germaitis, and here are the top stories for the week of November 30th, 2016. Experimental malware has highlighted the possibility that hackers might be able to turn headphones into microphones in order to snoop on computer users. Research by computer scientists at Ben Gurion University, Israel, has revealed that both headphones and loudspeakers present a potential bugging risk. The researchers put together proof-of-concept malware in order to validate the risk. Malware can use a computer as an eavesdropping device, even when a microphone is not present, muted, taped, or turned off, the researchers warn. In a paper, Speaker, Turn Speakers to Microphones for Fun and Profit, the researchers survey the scope of the risk and access potential countermeasures possible. Possible hardware-based defenses include using only active one-way speakers or deploying either white noise emitters or audio jammers. I think this is actually the creepiest news story I have read in a very long time, because
I think it is.
The potential for real spying is, like, it's so intrusive. You think that you've got it under control just by turning it off.
No.
Taping. Yeah, and if you use passive speakers on your computer, and it can be turned into a microphone.
Yeah.
Should we demonstrate this a little bit for those of you at home who don't understand the inner workings of a speaker and a microphone?
Yes, please.
So, Sasha, are you saying that we could have, instead of buying you a new microphone, we could have just put these on?
Could you imagine?
Can we just put those on your head? Yeah. It'd be cool.
That's right.
Welcome to the news. Okay, so this is just a pair of really great Thermaltake Esports headphones.
Mm-hmm.
Standard headphones, right? So you plug them into your computer and you don't think anything of it, and you use them to listen to music, and they're great.
Great.
Nothing to do with these headphones, but everything to do with the way speakers, microphones, everything like that works. So if I have these on, and let's just put these into an adapter here, and I'm going to plug this in over here, okay?
Right.
So I'm going to plug this into our mixing console, and I'm going to disconnect all three of our microphones.
Okay.
Okay? So now I've got a pair of headphones plugged into our mixing console to emulate for you what it would be like if you had a pair of headphones or a passive speaker on your computer.
Right. Once the microphones are off, I will tell everybody out loud all of my passwords to everything. Because the speakers or the microphones will be
off. Oh, right, yeah.
It'll be totally safe.
Picking up all the conversations. So remember, these are headphones, right? Okay, so I'm gonna start with Sasha.
Goodbye.
Okay, Sasha's gone.
Uh-oh.
There goes Erica.
Oh, no.
And here goes me.
Hello. Hello. What's that?
I'm creeped out.
These are headphones, folks. Headphones. This is not a microphone. I've just got them plugged into my computer or whatever. All right. I'm gonna plug us back in.
There's Erica. Say hi.
I'm back.
Sasha.
Hello.
And
I'm revived.
There's me.
That is...
I'm going to have
probably
to go back and listen to that.
The worst news story for
no,
fear-based.
No, I have more things to worry about.
Yes.
Because I'm going to be walking around my house now just imagining that everything and everyone can hear
so
me.
So don't have... Yeah. What if they're not plugged in? Then you're okay?
What if your computer has passive speakers built in?
And what computer doesn't? Mine does.
Then what do we do? How do we avoid this?
You can't put, despite the news story, you can't put tape over a speaker.
See, I have
doesn't
tape
work
on
that way.
All of my cameras.
We're
going
to have to do a demo on how to cut the wires in
these
gonna devices.
We're going to have to. We just created
You just can't win. Hackers always find a way.
Oh, boy.
And now you know.
Now you know.
Okay. Well, now that we're sad.
now we just put a damper on.
Right. Hard drive scrambling ransomware menaced more than 2,000 systems at San Francisco's public transit agency on Friday and demanded 100 bitcoins to unlock data. That's the equivalent of about $73,000 US.
Wow.
Yeah. Ticket machines were shut down and passengers were allowed to ride for free on Saturday, a busy post-Thanksgiving shopping day for the city, while IT workers scrambled to clean up the mess. A variant of the HDD cryptor malware infected 2,112 computers within the San Francisco Municipal Transportation Agency. These systems appear to include office admin desktops, CAD workstations, email and print servers, employee laptops, payroll systems, SLQ databases, lost and found property terminals, and station kiosk PCs. The worm-like malware automatically attacked the agency's network and was able to reach the organization's domain controller and compromise network-attached Windows systems. There are roughly 8,500 PCs, Macs, and other boxes in the agency's network. After the vulnerable computers were infected and their storage scrambled, they were rebooted by the malware, and rather than start their operating system, they instead displayed the message, "You hacked." Sorry, this part makes me laugh. "You hacked. All data encrypted. Contact for key." The ransomware's masterminds claimed in a statement on Sunday via email, "Our software is working completely automatically and we don't launch targeted attacks. SFMTA's network was very open and 2,000 server/PCs were infected by software." Wow, this is a lot of money, and seemingly it was an easy attack. So
yeah. There's so many folds to this story. We've talked about malware, mm-hmm. about crypto ransomware on the show before. And one of the things that keeps coming up, like I encounter this all the time, customers who are not so sure, why do I need to pay for ongoing maintenance? Why do we need to have someone here every month to run our maintenance and to make sure all of our systems are up to date? So understand, here is a network of thousands of computers, and thousands of computers are out of date, so much so that here's an exploit in Oracle software that was patched, not only revealed, but patched, fixed, more than a year ago. And yet, it was used by automated software to lock down their network. So how does that work? Well, why would anyone want to attack me? Nobody would want to attack me. Well, these bots, as the hackers have said, mm-hmm. go out on the internet and find susceptible systems. They don't care whose system it is.
Exactly.
If they can get 1% of the systems that they encrypt and damage the files to cough up money,
right,
then they've made a killing.
And they're bots. They're tireless.
They'll
work 24/7. They don't care. They'll search until they find something.
Absolutely. Absolutely. It's the call center mentality where you're just picking up the phone and dialing numbers, and one of those people out of every mm-hmm. 100 will buy.
Exactly.
And here we are, we're using it for malicious purposes, and nobody's really safe, and it's important to mm-hmm. keep your stuff up to date. Absolutely. Today, for example, if I may interject, and I know this is your show, Sasha, FH Tommy reminds us this is totally Sasha's show.
Thank you. I love you.
Today, this morning, 7 o'clock in the morning, it was unveiled that Firefox, the browser, has a zero-day exploit. Firefox itself, the web browser, can be exploited in such a way that it can compromise a user's computer. So Firefox, Mozilla, was very, very quick to bring out a patch. But did everyone install that patch? Have you installed that patch yet? You need to know that that exploit is there. So if you're not updating your system mm-hmm. and these kinds of things are found, and that's what happened here at mm-hmm. the transit system, right. It was found, but it was a year ago, and it never got patched. And right. So now, who knows what happens next?
Thank you, Robbie.
Hey, you know, this is your show.
Thanks for contributing to my show.
Yeah, I know. Okay.
The United States Navy has revealed that the names and social security numbers on 1,300 134,386 current and former employees has been leaked thanks to a compromise of a laptop used by a Hewlett Packard Enterprise Services staffer. The IT contractor and the Naval Criminal Investigative Service probed the data loss, finding that unknown individuals accessed the records. No information was released on the details of the incident, so we're uncertain if the laptop was stolen, infected with malware, or otherwise compromised. So we don't know a lot of information about this, in fact, really, except that, well, it was compromised. We don't know how, but we do know that the personal information of these, you know, fine individuals is out there somehow, somewhere. So
just more exploits going on, eh?
Yeah, this is somber day for news.
On a brighter note.
It's time for faster sustained IOPS on SD cards. SD cards have historically been associated with digital cameras, media players, and game consoles, and other relatively simple and appliance-like devices. In these roles, the cards are primarily needed to offer fast sequential read and write speeds, since they were typically just being asked to save and access one file at a time. But SD cards are becoming increasingly important as primary storage devices. Use cases that demand better random read and write performance to account for multiple apps making small read and writes to the cards in rapid succession. Boy. In recognition of these more complex use cases, the SD Association has introduced version 5.1 of the SD specification, which adds a new app performance class that guarantees buyers a minimum number of input-output operations per second, IOPS, just as the current speed classes guarantee minimum sequential writing speeds. The new A1 speed class promises that cards support sustained write speeds of at least 10 megabytes per second, at least 1,500 read IOPS, and at least 500 write IOPS. Additional speed classes will be introduced to meet market needs. The good news about this is because SD cards are really important in, like, the Raspberry Pi, right?
Yes. So, yeah. It's exactly what was coming to my mind, Sasha.
Yeah. So that's a great news story as far as accessibility of information.
I think so. Up to now, the SD cards, micro SD cards, you've got a camera and you need it to save very, very quickly and sequentially to that card, but reading is comparatively slow. So you put that same card in your phone, for example, and it's got all your apps. Or best example that you can give is the Raspberry Pi, I think. Right. This could have a big performance gain for things like the Raspberry Pi.
Right.
I think that's fantastic.
I think that's amazing news. This is also great news. Google's DeepMind AI has pioneered a new technology which allows robots to dream in order to improve their rate of learning. This follows after the company's recent announcement of its new lip reading software using artificial intelligence. The latest development differs from the previous research in which the company trained its AI to master a watch, listen, attend, and spell, WLAN, network structure whilst transcribing several hours of BBC footage. In precise explanation of its latest research, DeepMind explained that the aim of the study is to recognize phrases and sentences being spoken by a talking face, with or without the audio. Following its announcement earlier this month, DeepMind researchers partnered with Blizzard Entertainment in order to transform one of its games into a learning environment for AI. Its popular video game, StarCraft II, will be used to teach and test machine agents. In particular, researchers identified that StarCraft was an interesting testing environment for current AI research because it provides a useful bridge to the messiness of the real world. The dreams discovered by the researchers have allowed the AI to highlight different sections of the games that may be particularly challenging and repeat them until mastered. This technique was found to develop a total of 10 times speed increase in the rate of learning. That is amazing for computers.
Wow.
Way to go, AI. Where is Jeff today?
I find it hilarious if you ever get on to, like, get on to Google Image Search and do a search for DeepMind dreams.
Yeah. Oh.
And the things that this AI comes up with, like, you just go check it out. You have to see it to see what a computer dreams. Like, what does a computer dream?
And I wonder if they have reoccurring dreams.
Don't know.
I gotta find out.
I like it.
I know. It's like you always wondered what your dog or cat dreamed of. Now you can find out what your computer dreams of. I wonder, like, 1010. I don't know.
Zero, 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 one. It's like, oh, it's a nightmare. It's 0000001.
Thanks for watching the Category5.tv newsroom. Don't forget to like and subscribe for all your tech news with a slight Linux bias. And for more free content, be sure to check out our website. From the Category5.tv newsroom, I'm Sasha Dermatis.
Thanks, Sasha. This is Category 5 Technology TV, and it is episode number 480. All right. We ready to get into your viewer questions, viewer comments?
Yes.
What do we got? You were mentioning somebody in the chat room.
Yeah. We got a question from Sparkly Balls.
Hey, Sparkly.
So, any chance of a future on VPN, Robbie?
On VPNs? What do you want to know?
More of a UK.
Not tonight.
More of a UK-centric thing. You know, with the UK.
Oh, are you talking about being able to get around restrictions on Netflix?
Becoming law.
Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, with the new law coming out this week.
By the way, did you hear that Amazon Prime Video is coming to Canada on Thursday?
No way.
It was leaked at the CRTC.
No way. Yeah. I have Amazon Prime. This is perfect for me.
Oh, you're going to get it for free then?
Yeah.
Look at that. So you'll be able to stream videos and TV shows. And
that's
all that kind of stuff.
Amazing.
Yay.
I forgot to cancel my free 30 days of Amazon Prime. And so now I'm an Amazon Prime member.
You just have to
perfect.
Order a lot through our partner links to take advantage of the free shipping.
That's exactly what I do.
Here in Canada, our American friends are not sure what I'm talking about because it's like Amazon Prime has done video for a long time. Here in Canada, Prime is strictly free shipping. Essentially, right?
Right.
Like that's it's the amazing. Perk.
I think I get like a little bit of like storage for photos or something. I get something randomly weird. That I don't use.
But we don't have any video service. So when all the video stores, the DVD rental stores shut down.
Blockbuster.
I know, Blockbuster. Where'd you go?
It was my Friday night.
I grew up at Blockbuster. You go in and they had popcorn. It was awesome.
Do you have like the full life-size, you know, Master Chief?
Not Blockbuster. Bandito. That's the one I'm thinking.
Bandito.
Not Blockbuster. Blockbuster.
Yeah, you'd go there and then I used to...
I wanted Blockbuster to go out of business. Sorry. Bandito was the one.
Bandito, but that was the best because you go and get the popcorn and then you have a little like popcorn trail behind you.
Blockbuster was not a nice store. They were the ones who charged way too much for movies so that they didn't have late fees.
And then I had late fees
all the time. We're digressing so seriously. Here's the thing. When all of them shut down, so Blockbuster, they shut down and I was happy.
Yeah.
Bandito closed down. Yeah. That's the one that we loved.
Yeah.
Then I was sad. There was nowhere to get movies. So then I started looking around. Amazon Prime lets you rent new release movies.
Yeah.
But they're not in Canada. So you can't, where do you go to get new release movies in Canada? So we found on our Roku, there's actually a Cineplex store and you can rent new release movies. It's fantastic. And it's cheap. It's affordable. Mm-hmm. But now Amazon Prime, of course, is kind of like a Netflix alternative. Mm-hmm. We need it here in Canada because all we have is Netflix, and I love Netflix, but there's no competition. And you can say that Bell's there and Shomi's there, but no, Shomi has already gone out of business.
Exactly. Shomi's gone.
Yeah.
What about Crave?
Crave? I've never even heard of Crave, so that's
maybe
how well their marketing department is doing.
Maybe it's a Toronto thing.
Is it a Toronto thing?
Maybe.
Is it spelled like C'Rave? Is that how it's done?
That would be smart, but it's just Crave.
So we've got that coming. How do we even get on that? Amazon Prime.
Sparkly. Sparkly balls.
All right. Yeah, right. He's asking about
VPNs. We need like a little light bulb.
We're not going to talk about illegal VPNs.
This episode is 100% dedicated to sparkly balls today.
It's what computers dream about. All right. So let's get into viewer comments and questions. No, we will not do illegal VPNs.
Nope.
If you want to learn how to build a VPN, sure, but not for illegal purposes. That's what my point was.
So, we got one from Andy.
17022. Nice.
Hi, guys.
Hey, Andy.
I just wanted to let you know I haven't watched live for a couple weeks. However, this week I did. And I can now report that the live feed from your website is working again on Samsung Smart TVs.
Fantastic.
Yes. For anyone with a smart TV, just use the built-in browser and go to live.cat5.tv. Wait for the feed to load and click the tiny icon to make it full screen. I'm also pleased to report that the noisy ad that used to break into the audio seems to have gone away, and keep up the excellent work.
No way. Okay. So I wonder if upgrading our website somehow fixed the problem that you had with that smart TV. Because you remember Andy used to have trouble with that, and an advertisement would come up and he'd hear the ad over top of our voices. And
you don't want to hear that.
Well, yeah.
And I love the new website upgrades.
Cheers. Yeah, I hope you're enjoying it as well at home.
So
we've got a lot of cool stuff. Today, actually, I added a link in the footer of the website. Thanks to PJ for emailing me and saying, where'd the feeds go? Oh, yeah. So check out the subscribe button in the footer of the website. You'll be able to get our RSS feeds. And incidentally, we've adopted the kind of WordPress way of doing things as well. If you go to category5.tv/feed, you'll actually get an aggregated feed of all of our shows. So that's kind of so you get the newsroom, you get Category 5 Technology TV, you get New Every Day, you get the Pixel Shadow. Pixel Shadow, she's got headphones on. She doesn't know what's happening, but she's over there playing Mind Test. So, that's kind of cool. Category5.tv/feed or Category5.tv/subscribe if you want individual feeds. Yeah.
Sparkly Balls would like to clarify that his question was not meant for illegal purposes, but more to stop the government from invading our privacy.
Okay, so
there you go.
Secretive. Okay, so you mean to be able to connect and to a private virtual private network at home from work kind of thing?
Mm-hmm. And actually,
we could show that kind of thing. It's pretty platform dependent. I'd be more apt. I mean, tell me if there's something specific you want to know. I think anyone who wants to do VPN, there's a lot of resources out there. I think more exciting than that would be using like tunnels and using SSH to tunnel into servers and things like that so that you can create your own tunnel-based access to an internal LAN.
What's fun in my mind is how little I really know. I don't know things until I actually learn them on the show. So I'm just picturing real tunnels right now.
Yeah.
That's great. It's just
tunnels. No, that's exactly what we're talking about. A big tree with a hole dug through it and big a road.
Tunnels. What about a ski tunnel?
Ski tunnels? Yeah. Absolutely.
That's
absolutely.
What I was thinking.
L. Howard asks, do you have any videos on accessing Unraid remotely outside of a home network? So that is actually an interesting question in light of what I just said.
Yeah.
The way that you'd want to do that is through an SSH tunnel because you would not want to have your Unraid computer, your server, internet accessible. Do not do it. It's a Samba server. That's not a safe thing to do. Reason being is then people would be able to access your internal files. These are probably private files. Unraid was never set up to be a web accessible cloud device. That's not what it's for. It is for a closed internal network. Opening it up to the outside world is a huge exploit, not something that I would safely promote. Using an SSH tunnel, though, if you had a server on your network or you had Unraid itself with SSH installed, you could set up a SSH with a firewall, use CSF or something. We've covered it on the show. Do a search on our website. You could create an SSH tunnel into your network, and then you could access your Unraid server via LAN on your network. Performance would be pretty poor because you're over the internet, but so that's what I would say to that. So there are no videos on it because I would never recommend that setup. So
it's good to know.
Mm.
So Trigger Hippie was watching our tutorial on using DSLR cameras.
Oh yeah,
and
with Wirecast.
Yeah, and he was wondering with the telescreen Wirecast, and it's like he was like, "This is a cool video, man." And one quick question, and I'm like, "You know what? Let's answer it." So, have you ever been able to get audio via HDMI out of the D5100? My Decklink mini recorder is not registering a beep coming from the camera.
Why would I do that? I suppose if I had a microphone plugged into my camera, like if you had a nice mic, I would use a completely separate audio source. How we do it, D5100 HDMI output for video. But do keep in mind, HDMI carries audio as well. So yes, you could add the audio source as long as your capture device supports it. But I would always recommend using a separate audio source. So we have ours go into a mixing console through a Behringer compressor and into a BBE sonic maximizer out to a balanced input on the computer and then mix everything together in Wirecast. So I wouldn't suggest using the camera as your audio input device. It would be a cheap and dirty way to do it if you plugged a microphone in, but then you get no compression, you get no filters or anything. You can't adjust the volume the same way. Wirecast 7 does have some added features for the audio mixer, but it still doesn't equate to the sound quality you're going to get from using external devices. So I'd stay away from that, but it is possible. The way that you would do it is add HDMI video as a source and then add to that source HDMI audio from your capture, from your deck link. And then hope that it's in sync.
Yes.
That's the other thing. Sometimes that can get out of sync, but you see how it works.
Yeah.
Look like a bad dubbed movie.
Yeah.
Not careful.
Or if your YouTube video is still running and the... hate that. Well, we got one last question.
Oh, yeah?
And if any more, we got in the chat room, give us a question. We're all here. We got Sasha and myself. We got one from Zika, Zawaz. Watch our future about recovering video from unreadable mini DVDs.
Oh, right. Okay.
Yeah, using Linux.
Nika.
So,
hey, Nika.
Many helpful things. So it was so helpful. She's thanking us so much. My mom passed away. She had all these mini DVDs, and I can finally watch the fond memories of her.
That's awesome. So, you never know how a tutorial is going to help people.
Yeah.
We did a tutorial, Eric and I, actually, back in Studio C. So this is going way back.
Way back.
How to recover video from those old micro DVDs. That can't be played on a DVD player because you used to have to plug it into the camera and the camera would decode it.
Yeah.
But we showed how to get that. So I'm so glad that was able to help you, Nika, and bring some of those memories back for you. Thank you for sending your message. Okay, Jack Thomas. Jack watched our video about flying a micro drone. Lots of people checking out this video and commenting says, got my first mini quad today and it has no speed control. I've tried flying it before watching this, and let me just say, now I have to buy a new computer screen. Sorry about that, Jack.
That's something I would do.
Yeah. Art76 also saw the same video and said, great video, encourages me to keep practicing with mine. Thanks. And this is the video where we taught how to fly a teeny drone. And RetroGamer33 says, I'm getting my fourth quadcopter thanks to you guys. I think I'm getting a bit obsessed with them. That's in their words.
I think a little bit.
A little bit. Have you seen my supply of drones? Yeah, I can tell you all about obsession. please consider, as you're purchasing these drones, make sure you go to cat5.tv/fly, and we've got a selection there of drones that we love to fly. Want to take William DeLeon?
Yes. So William DeLeon posted a comment on our video about setting up Plex Media Server.
Oh, yes.
On a Raspberry Pi.
Jeff and I. That was a fun episode. Getting a lot of great response as well.
Oh, yeah, for sure. And he says, hi, I really enjoyed the video, and I not only follow the instructions, but I'm really happy with the Plex setup. And now I have, you know, he never had that before, and he's just saying thanks.
Awesome. Thank you. And that's, again, cool that somebody's found a video on our site and figured out, you know, follow the tutorial and get things up and going.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome, William. Glad to hear it. Sasha, Christopher Kevin Lee, have you got his print out there?
I have not.
You don't?
I do not have it.
We didn't print a copy for you?
We didn't print a copy for me.
Don't we have a drone to do this for us?
Yeah, come on. Fly it over. I thought I gave you a printout.
No, you did not.
Okay.
Thought I was sadly left out. Oh, here.
Oh, they're...
Look. Ah, go team.
How did that happen?
I don't know.
Christopher Kevin Lee. I'm hoping Microsoft doesn't take over Linux in one way or another. I don't want Linux crashing and having BSOD, so black screen.
Blue
screen of death.
LOL. Oh, that makes me think.
I've been using Linux between 1.5 years to 2 years, and I found I have much less problems with Linux. Mm. I do get old issues here and there, like his Android phone won't mount in Linux Mint. Okay,
really?
So I guess Christopher Kevin Lee is having some fears from the last news story where there was that Microsoft...
Yep.
Joining the Linux Foundation.
So I think that's where that fear is coming from.
They're just jumping on the Linux train.
I think that Linux will stand strong and will not end up taking on the issues that Microsoft has.
Yes. Oh, absolutely.
Oh, no.
I'll tell you, first of all, there's an old saying that says, if you can't beat them, join them. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Think about that for a second. There's some meaning behind that. Now, there is an old screensaver for Linux, Chris, that is a blue screen of death. And I would love to see that added to some Linux systems in light of Microsoft joining the Linux Foundation.
Oh,
I think we're going to put that on our systems here.
So
instead of a screensaver, just BSODs. So great.
And then
so
you touch
you know what we'll do?
Trick.
Yes.
We'll do it before a show, and then Jeff's going to come in.
Just BSOD all the computers.
And then we're gonna
oh, look, you upgraded to Windows. Not going to happen. Okay, we got one more.
And I think I can relate to Sean White here.
Hey, Sean.
Sean White saw the episode of 476 and our show about mobile malware.
Oh, yes.
Being in the IT security technology contracting field, I run into these types of issues with many of my users. This is a resourceful 10,000-foot view anyone can learn, dive into the issues, and very well done. I attempt to secure the human as much as possible with each client, but become winded and get a bit discouraged when their eyes begin to glaze over.
It's tough to explain to end users, and you do it over and over again, and I think that's part of what makes Category 5 fun, is if you can find the content, there's a lot of great content there, and if you can find it, hone in on it, share it, then you don't have to repeat yourself quite as often. And episode 476 was a prime example of a great interview where we were talking about mobile malware and how it's on the rise and what users need to be aware of and conscious about. And so if you haven't seen it yet, check out episode 476 at category5.tv. And that's a great resource. And I appreciate your feedback and your compliments as well.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you so much, Sean. All right, is that that's all of our questions that we've got, comments and everything for today.
Yeah.
Beyond that, I just want to thank everyone again for supporting the show.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, we're kind of coming up to the Christmas season, and I know that you're shopping online, and you can use our partner links, be it eBay, Amazon. We've got Newegg Canada. We've got a whole bunch there at category5.tv. Just click on support us. And it really, really helps us out if you do your shopping that way. Mm-hmm. It doesn't cost you any extra. It just gives us a commission. So that really, really helps. And I appreciate also those who have contributed with a direct donation. And that's really helping us out with some of our expenses, from rent to
insurance to insurance, every 2 weeks of wondering what's going to break next.
Yeah. Oh, you feel me. Yeah.
I feel
putting in
you.
A new hard drive this month, and a new RAID controller, and a new microphone for Sasha, and all these things that are needs that show up. So
I quite like these new microphones.
Very good. Very good. Okay. Hey, you remember Amp Sound? These are in Canada now. They're also available in the United States and all around the world. Make sure you go to cat5.tv/ampsound. And these are earbuds, Bluetooth earbuds, so wireless headphones that double as a hearing aid.
Okay? No way.
Yes way. So they actually help you. They're not a hearing aid per se. You don't need to go for a medical consultation. You don't have to pay $3,000. These give you better hearing when you're wearing them. So if you're having trouble hearing, this is a great either, you know, something cheaper than a hearing aid to help you to hear, but also could be something alternative when you're not wanting to wear a hearing aid all the time. You want to listen to music, you know, and then if someone's talking to you, switch to hearing aid mode without having to take them out and switch to your hearing aids and all this kind of stuff.
Oh, that's pretty convenient.
Right? I love
something
that.
I love this kind of stuff. Christmas list this year.
Mm-hmm.
Then you have, that's awesome.
There you go. So they're all ready to go. These, you remember when we first introduced these on the show, it was in prototype stage and was raising money on Indiegogo.
Yep.
And now they're available for you, cat5.tv/ampsound. So check that out. It's all the time that we have for this week. Can you believe? The hour kind of flies by, doesn't it?
If I wish it was 2 hours every week.
Oh, every week?
Yes.
Sasha, we don't have enough hard drive space for that.
That's right.
We're just trying to get to the point where we can support our one-hour show. We're doing our best.
I dream big. I'm like a computer dreams. AI.
Apparently, you have good dreams.
I do have good dreams.
I know. You're lucky.
I have. I will one day when we have lots of extra time, like in a second hour, I will tell you about some of my best dreams. But right now, I'll tell you, most of the time they include orangutans.
You could blog about it.
I could. Oh, huh? I have a blog.
Yes.
Dearly neglected blog.
Remember when you were a part of Category 5 TV 3 years ago and you had a blog, but then you left Category 5 for a year?
Oh, yes.
Was it a year or was it two years you were gone?
I was gone for only one.
One.
Oh.
So now that you're back, are you going to start blogging again? You can blog about your orangutan dreams.
You know what? Let's.
Do it.
And by let's, I mean I will. I will blog again.
All right.
I believe you.
For I am sure you would not practice upon my inexperience.
I will do this. I promise.
There has to be a Gilbert and Sullivan reference in every show. That's our new rule. All right, folks. That's all the time that we have. So have a fantastic week. Great to see Erika Lalonde again. Few and far between. Come back soon.
Oh, yes. And I'll be back.
Give me a heads up.
Thanks for having me.
He had to do it.
He had to do it.
1 minute left.
Yes. See you, everybody.
Bye.
Good night.